I want to open this video by saying if there is an update to this guide at any point in time, there should be a little card that popped up at the top of this video, but there'll also be a link in the description for any updated video covering these same bosses. Hey, this is Pixel. The Rogue Legacy 2 Arcane Hollows update came out just today, and with it they have brought two new sub-bosses and a new boss. Now to unlock the primary boss, you have to beat both of the sub-bosses, but luckily these bosses aren't too difficult. Let's take a moment to address the attack patterns and strategies for how to beat both of these Void Beast sub-bosses. Void Beast Gongheads is probably the first sub-boss that you'll run into. This one manifests as two different halberd or spear users, and their attacks are very similar to the generic enemy that you run into. Here in the example that I have, I was using a trait that made all of the enemies black, so unfortunately you can't see their art, but I beat them in the first shot because they are fairly easy. Now the biggest trick here is just make sure when you go in to fight this boss, just have full health. If you're leveled up plenty, more than likely you could just tank through this enemy as long as you have a class that has that ability. If not, their moves are also very easy to telegraph. First move you'll find them doing is a spear toss, and the difference here between the regular enemies where they throw them directly horizontal and throw one spear, here the Void Beast will throw two and they can throw them at different angles. If you see them preparing for that spear toss, you might want to get out of the way, make a little bit of room so that you can properly evade the spear. The second move you're going to see them doing is this jump, where they jump and then leave fireballs underneath them. When they telegraph this move, stay on the ground, don't jump yourself, because you want to be able to see those fireballs in the air so you can get between the spaces on the ground. The third attack is simple enough, it's just a regular dash. This is a no-frills attack. The most dangerous thing during it is the other enemy, so as long as they're not doing anything, just jump up and over, and then when the enemy leaves itself open after the dash, score a bunch of hits. Finally, they have an attack where they raise their fist above their head, and then they cast out about three spirits that work as kind of homing missiles. These spirits will hang around and track after you until you hit them with your weapon in one way or another, and that will kill them. As with many of the two enemy bosses you find in Rogue Legacy 1 and 2, the trick here is to focus on one at a time and try to get one of them dead, because the fight becomes exponentially easier once you only have one enemy to deal with. Luckily in this fight, the enemies have long pauses between their attacks and they telegraph their moves really far in advance, so it's very easy to just dodge the move, come in and attack. Also, in this particular boss fight, they don't hit very hard, so if you have a character with enough HP, you can likely go in there with full HP and just tank the whole thing without even having to think about it too much. Void Beast Murmur is likely to be the second Void Beast that you come up against. You will require the Void Dash in order to even reach this particular Void Beast. Now, this sub-boss is not like other sub-bosses that we've seen in Rogue Legacy 2. This is more like the original Heirloom Trials, where you have to do a number of jumps and make sure you don't get hit. But the challenging part of Void Beast Murmur is a single room that large fireballs are being spewed out at you and big waves of void that you'll have to dash through, because the Void Dash allows you to be invulnerable to void while you're dashing. What's important about this room is understanding that there is a little bit of a pattern to how the fireballs come at you. So the void waves are your money waves. As long as you see them coming, you can dash forward right away and you can make some progress in the room. The challenge is really in the radiation balls that get thrown, because in every wave of those, there's only one missing and you need to find that gap to get through it. A lot of times that gap is at the very top. In order to do that, you're gonna have to spin kick off it and get high enough in the air, potentially even spin kicking multiple times to get up there, to get up and over the wave. The trick here is that you always have to be keeping an eye on what's coming in the next wave so that you can navigate yourself between the various spheres. There's one particularly tricky part where you actually end up in a little bit of a rut, and then when you come out, there are brambles on the wall behind you. You'll need to wait for a good opportunity to hop out and then come and clear some of those out, because if you get a wave that you need to climb up, you're going to want to make sure that those spheres don't push you into those brambles. You will eventually make it to a large statue, and that is Void Beast Murmur. Now, if you've made it to Void Beast Murmur with enough health, you can just tank the whole thing and then just keep whacking away until you eventually kill it. It doesn't have a lot of hit points. It's pretty easy to take down. If you're a little lower on health or you're trying to play it more purely, more conservatively, then you're going to want to time those waves because you never really know what's going to come out. And if the gap isn't right in front of you, then you're going to have to get either hit or you're going to have to get pushed way back. The best way here is just time it, do a few hits, then back up, deal with the oncoming wave, come in, take a few more hits, and then back off again. If you keep up this strategy, Void Beast Murmur will be just like Void Beast Gongheads and will be a complete pushover. Once both the Void Beasts are dead, that opens up the path to Estuary Enoch and the final fight for this particular update. If you like this video, well then leave a like on this video, and if you'd like to see more Rogue Legacy videos, tips, guides, strategies, I've made a whole slew of Rogue Legacy videos on my channel. Take a look at those, and if you haven't subscribed yet and you like those videos, well then consider subscribing. Thanks for watching, and until next time, this has been Pixel.